What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm gonna be doing a little newborn or baby must-have items that I recommend to you guys. I do want to make a disclaimer. These are items that I've enjoyed or that I personally like. If you guys do not enjoy these items, then you are more than welcome to try anything else, but these are items that I truly do recommend to you guys. I did make sure I tested out everything that I'm showing you in this video. She is already 6 weeks, hence why it did take a little bit too long, but you know, it is what it is. I'm trying to pick out the best items. Before I get into this video, make sure you guys go ahead and hit that subscribe button and hit your post notification so you guys can stay alert for whenever I post a new video. Also, if you guys do not follow me on social media, make sure you go ahead and do that. They will be right here on the screen as well as in the description box down below. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I don't want to make this intro incredibly long, so we're gonna go ahead and hop right into this video. The very first item that I have is this little sleeper. So these are the ones that I've been, or I was using, well actually I still use these, but not the newborn size, because homegirl is wearing 3 month clothing at 6 weeks. I cannot believe it, but she is huge, or at least she looks huge to me. I like these personally because they have a two-way zipper. Say you have to change her diaper in the night or during the day, whenever, you go ahead and you unzip the one at the bottom, and you unzip this one, you pull her little legs out, and then you go ahead and change your diaper. It's literally the easiest thing. She still wears these literally every single night, or sometimes she wears like the sleep gowns. So let me show you the sleep gowns. These are also one of my favorites because you literally just put her in, and then whenever you want to change her diaper, you just go ahead and roll it up, and then you go ahead and change her diaper. I do prefer these just a little bit more because when it comes to this, I have to put it over her head, and this you kind of just slip her arms in and legs. She hates stuff going over her face, and sometimes I struggle to literally get it down her, and she starts fussing and crying, and it's just a little problem. Another sleeping item that I have is these sleep swaddles. So I personally am not a fan of the wrap ones. There's just a lot less convenient for me. She loves these. What she does not love is having her arms tied down. We of course tested that. We would wrap her in like the blankets and tie her arms down. We wrap her up in these and tie her arms down. No, homegirl would wake up in the morning with her arms like this. She hated them. She would literally try and wiggle her way out of them. So what I do with these, I just go ahead and wrap it from like here down and leave her arms up, and then I just put on some gloves so she doesn't like scratch her face or whatever. She does have like a little long sleeve onesie underneath, and then this over her, of course. Another, this is not like a sleep item, but you could wrap her up in this as a swaddle, is these muslin blankets. I love these because they are humongous. Literally, it can wrap me up. And if it can wrap me up, then that is literally like a go-to. I don't really use these for her to sleep in. I more use these as car seat covers because it's what I find the best use out of, especially when we go out to public places, because I don't like her to be seen by other people because of like el mal ojo or whatever. I just don't want anyone with bad intentions or negative energy to be looking at my baby. So every time we do go out, I make sure she has something to cover herself up, of course. So yeah, definitely recommend these. I can show you how long they are, but they're incredibly long, like literally incredibly long, and if I wanted to, I can wrap myself up with it. Another item that I have is burp clots. Burp clots are a must. I literally have so many of these because they go by so fast, especially if they spit up or you're literally feeding them and they're spilling milk. You just have to go ahead and wipe them down. So these do get dirty pretty quick. I just throw them in the wash, whatever. But I do have several just in case I haven't washed that day. But you know, I do also enjoy these because whenever she wakes up in the middle of the night, I go ahead and breastfeed her laying down. Because of that, milk does tend to spill onto the bed covers. So I put this underneath her, and then it literally catches any milk and it doesn't stay in the bed, because if you guys know, milk stains. It is not like water. It will stain. So definitely recommend these. Make sure you guys go pick some up. And then the next items that I have like on my recommended list are not any more clothing pieces or like fabric. It's more like handy dandy tools or medicines, ointments, you know the drill. But yeah, I love this. This is a nail filer. It is so easy, so convenient, so much better for your baby, at least in my opinion, because I do not like using the nail clippers because their nails are literally, or their fingers are so tiny, and I'm so scared of pinching their skin and them crying, or I find the nail filer so tedious because you're moving your hand back and forth and then your baby's literally moving like this trying to beat you up. Yeah, you know what I mean. So it's just a lot harder for me. So I go ahead and use one of these. Let me show you guys how this works. These are different textures depending on their age or whatever. So like whatever is softer for them. But basically you just go ahead and you pick the one that's recommended for your baby. And then you change the setting. And then you just go ahead and drill. Files her nails down pretty quick. And she doesn't mind it. I'll usually do it while she's feeding. And then I grab her little hand and I grab her little hand and I file it down. The other thing that I have is this little outlet machine. It's like a car. It's a portable sound machine. I do go ahead and put it on the car seat, of course, to like hang it. And then it has time settings right here. You can have it for 15 minutes, 30 minutes, or 60 minutes. And then it has the volume buttons to lower it down and lower it up. It's not on, but you know. And then you turn it on and then it has different noises. The next items that I have, this one, by far, hands down, has worked a million times on this. This is gripe water. So this one, what it does, it relieves stomach discomfort, gas, colic, hiccups, and like fussiness. We don't really use it for like the other reasonings. It's more if we know that she has colic and it's being really fussy. This is when we go ahead and give her this. Sometimes at night, she does not want to go to sleep because she is crying nonstop. And that's when we figure out that she has a stomach problem and she's in so much discomfort. So we go ahead and give her some of these and then she falls asleep and she lets us sleep because, ooh, I need my sleep. I still need my sleep. Also, this is more like a Hispanic thing that I've noticed, but if your baby also has colic or whatever, you can make them té de manzanilla. So it's just like a tea. I don't know what manzanilla really is in English, so I can't really explain it. So that's another thing if you guys want to, or if you guys already do. Then I also have this micellar water from Mustela. It's not micellar water, what the heck, cleansing water. So this is convenient for when you don't take your baby a bath that day. I usually take her a bath every morning, so when it comes to the nighttime, I just go ahead and I rub this all over her body just so she's cleansed, all over her diaper area. You can literally put this on their face, anywhere. I did see on some reviews that this has helped with their baby's acne. My baby did have a lot of baby acne the first couple of weeks, but what I did is I went ahead and put my own breast milk on her face and it literally cleared up within days. But I did see that a lot of moms did try this and this also helped them. But yeah, I do recommend this one. This one I do recommend. And then I also have some diaper rash cream. My baby, for the first couple of weeks, she was rashing up intensely. She was rashing up. I literally could not figure out what the hell was going on. So I just went ahead and changed her diaper. She was wearing Pampers, now she's wearing Huggies. I do see a difference. Sometimes she still gets a little bit of a rash, but it's definitely not how she had it before. This has definitely helped. I do also use like an Aquaphor rash ointment that has helped out my baby a lot. That one I do use in between her arm creases or her leg creases sometimes when I see a little bit of redness, because I don't know if it's like the friction or whatever, but she does get red because she does have a little bit of rolls, just a little bit. But I do go ahead and put that and then it soothes it out and it helps her. The other item on my list is this. What is this called? Cologne. This baby cologne. This is the Menin baby cologne, but it's literally by far hands down the best baby cologne ever existed. It just smells really great. It's way better than all the other baby colognes. Literally smells great. You can get it at, I don't really know where you can get this. My sister-in-law got it at like a Telo Pan, as I think that's what it's called, or I'm pretty sure you can get it like a Michoacana or like El Rancho, any like shop that's Hispanic based, you will probably find one of these. So if you can figure out how to get your hands on one of these, I do recommend it because it is great and it smells delicious. And every time I put this on her and someone holds her, they literally first thing that they say is, wow, your baby smells so good. My girl, I know, get yourself one of these. This is amazing. Another thing that we do enjoy is her milk dispenser. So my baby is like 90% breastfed, and every once in a while she does get a little bit of Similac, whether it's like once a day or once every other day, she does get a little bit in. Also because it's very good with vitamin D, just because breast milk doesn't supply a lot of vitamin D as it is. Or you can go ahead and give her these baby drops. So this is a liquid vitamin D. If you are fully breastfeeding, just go ahead and put a little bit of this in your breast milk, or like wrap it around your nipple, of course, and then they suck on it and then they get this little vitamin D. So I usually like alternate, just because I do not give a lot of Similac as it is, but this has definitely helped us whenever we're going out, and this is the option that we are giving her. Another thing that I really enjoy is her little flower. Oh, you see that? This is awesome when it comes to taking them a bath. I enjoy it. Like, I really think this is one of the items that you guys should buy, or it's a must. Mine is a dupe of the original Baby Bloom flower thingy. I got mine for $15 at Ross. Usually they go for 40 bucks, and I just got myself a deal. But you know, that's what I've been using. Just go ahead and put it in the sink or wherever you want to put it. You place your baby in there and you take her or him a bath. It is great. She enjoys it. It's a lot more comfortable than you having to hold your baby and take them a bath, or having to bend down and put them inside a tub. That's very not it for me. I'd rather stand up than sit down on my knees and take my baby a bath. So this is what I prefer. And then another thing that I do prefer is this thingy. I forgot what this is called. A boppy lounger thingy. I got this on Facebook Market for, I believe, $20. Or 15. I think these go for like $35. So I got a steal. Once again, I got a steal. And then this is great for when your baby is awake and moving around. You just go ahead and pop them in here. I do recommend you guys get something like that to lounge them around in. Or also, say you're doing like some cleaning or something, you could put them in there. I don't really gravitate to put them in this like while I'm doing other things, just because I don't prefer it. If I am doing like housework or whatever, I do put them on a rocker that I have in my room that you just rock. I will show you guys in a second. Or a swing that we have downstairs that they can swing in. I'm not gonna really go and show you the swing, but I can pop it up right here. This is what the swing looks like. I don't know the name of it, but it will be in the description box down below. And then for the rocker, let me show you. So this is the rocker that we have. It just literally like rocks them. It has the things, and then it has settings right here to turn it on, change the sound into music or whatever, and rocking settings. But yeah, I do recommend something like this or similar, just so your baby can be in and lounge around while you do other housework or whatever you have to do. Another item that I have is my new breastfeeding pillow. So this is awesome when you're breastfeeding up, like in an upright position, just so you don't have to hold your baby like with your arms like this. They of course just lay on this, you pop them on, and then they feed. So this is great. It's also really good for when I'm sleeping and I want like a little pillow. I'll lay on this sometimes. I do also recommend you guys to get a baby monitor. I recently just bought it. I did not have one for the longest, but it is great for when I am downstairs and the baby is upstairs. This is the one that I use, this one right here. What is this called? The VTech one. So you go ahead and connect both of these to the wall. You can mount this. It comes with the mounting system as well. And then you can download the app and connect it, or have it connected to your phone, so you can literally see it from your phone anywhere that you are at. At first I wasn't gonna get it, but I'm actually really glad that I did, because it has been really easy and convenient. And sometimes if I'm eating, I do wanna be able to see how my baby is doing. Now, the very last thing I have on my list is my diaper bag. Because you cannot, literally, like, a diaper bag is one of the most top things that you guys need, especially for a baby, because you literally have to take it everywhere you go. No matter if you're going to your parents' house, or whether you're going to a family's house, literally anywhere you go, you need to take one of these, because it holds everything that you need. I carry her diapers, I carry extra clothes, I carry her bottles, I literally carry everything that I need in here. What I like about mine is that in this pocket you can put her bottles in, and it keeps the temperature that you had them in. And then on this side, it has like the wipes thingy, and you can literally pull the wipes out from in here. Oh, my glasses are in there for now, but this is awesome. And then inside here has little sections for the diapers, sections to put your baby's clothes in. And then in the back, it has this zipper that you pull out. It makes like a little diaper changing area, and then it has a changing pad. You place the changing pad inside, and then you change your baby in it. I think that's pretty much it. If I miss anything that I really enjoy, I will go ahead and link it down below for you guys. Oh, I did forget one last thing, and that is my baby Moises, which is a baby bassinet. I have that one downstairs. I was sleeping downstairs for the first couple of weeks of my recovery. So having that instead of bringing the crib all the way downstairs was so much beneficial, so much easier. So if you guys want to, I say go ahead and get something like that. That is the last item on my list. If you guys do have any items that you guys would like to recommend to me, go ahead and leave those down below. I'll be more than welcome to try them out. But yeah, that's pretty much it. That's all I have for this video. If you guys enjoyed, make sure you go ahead and hit those thumbs up buttons down below. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys next week. Bye.